Well, here we are on YouTube, and here is a new segment that we've been trying out lately. There they are on YouTube.
Welp, there Welp, they are on YouTube.
There they are on YouTube. So
that's right.
It's kind of a little idea that we've been thinking about actually for a long time. It's kind of a weird situation for us to be in because there's a lot of bands that you and I grew up with. In some ways, we're kind of jealous that other people get to like hear those for the first time.
Absolutely.
And I think that's what draws in reaction channels. To be honest, that's what a reaction channel kind of is. It's like you found someone on YouTube that you think, oh, this is like my friend. And I want to show my friend this music and right. see what they think of the music. That's sort of what reaction channels are to some extent.
Yeah, you're experiencing that first time listen of a song with somebody who's now hearing the song for the first time. You want to engage with that reactor to say, yeah, I see what I'm talking about. Yeah. So Nathan and I, we're going to be doing that a lot on our channel. Is we're going to basically react to other reactors, see how they're reacting and breaking down the songs of our youth and our... when we were young, and I guess the youth of today listening to the youth of yesterday's songs. And Guns N' Roses, needless to say, was a huge band that Nathan and I listened to back in the late 80s, early 90s. I mean, this is the biggest bad boy band in the world at the time. They were huge. I mean, they're still big now, selling out stadiums and not even releasing any new music and doing that. They're just that big of a legacy band today. Nathan, we've got a couple of reactors today reacting to some Guns N' Roses songs. The first one is, well, the name of his YouTube channel, Nathan, is Hiphoppoet. So I would assume he...
That's probably like his wheelhouse.
Is like right. He's a hip-hop. That's right. So he's a hip-hop guy listening to rock and roll or heavy metal for the first time. I would suspect he probably wasn't raised on Guns N' Roses, right? So this is very... He's lucky. He's lucky he gets to listen to this stuff because, as you know, Guns N' Roses is a big band, big draw. And people want to see what he has to say about GNR. Now, he's going to be listening to a song... Funny enough that it's actually not an original Guns N' Roses song. It's Mama Kin, which is actually an Aerosmith song. But nonetheless, he's going to listen to Guns N' Roses' cover of Mama Kin. Of course, originally recorded by Aerosmith. So let's check out his reaction, shall we?
2 through 3s and F and M bullets are ripped through tissue. Better say your last goodbyes, cause your fam gon' miss you. A shooting star, so them headshots is not gon' miss you. A young coach, so I'm playing games with her mental.
So that must be his... It must be his original... It's pretty clever if you think about it, right? Because you're going to get, you know, hundreds of thousands of views on your channel. Mm-hmm. That's a good way to plug your product, right? People are almost forced to listen to your song right. before you get into the... Yeah, so it's...
Hey,
yeah.
I'll be fair. When we first started our channel, the little, like, mix at the beginning was my song. That was my song that I mixed.
Oh, there you go. I also like how he has plugged YouTube quite a bit already. We have YouTube, the YouTube symbol... He's definitely saying, Welp, here I am on YouTube. He's making it very known.
Welp, there he is on YouTube.
And you can give him money via the Cash App there as well. So if anyone wants to give him some money for his reaction.
Guns N' Roses with a song called Mama Kin. Never heard this song. Let's get down to the rabbit hole of Guns N' Roses. Let's get it.
It's true. It's a rabbit hole, Nate. There's no doubt about that.
He's not pausing it.
Is he looking for something? Is there like a spider crawling on his wall or is he watching a tennis match up there?
This is how he listens to music. He kind of like looks around and listens to music.
We bop our heads too. I agree. Fair point. You know, we bop our heads. And I do like that he's not pausing the song. He's listening to the whole song. That's good. Mm-hmm. That's great. But I've never seen that before. It's unique. It's unique. Maybe. Not a criticism. It's unique.
Maybe he's in the zone.
And I will say, I don't think I've ever heard this studio version of the song. I know the live version that GNR does on GNR Lies, their EP, but I've never actually heard the studio version of this performance, to be fair. So good job to Hiphoppoet for pulling that deep cut out. Wow, look at that.
I like the little lines that he's got down there. It's like
oh, yeah, it's showing that it's old school. Yeah. It's old school. This is an old school recording. It's black and white film. You know, we got this... he's got a film projector type film in him. I like that. It's that old school. Yeah, it's old school rock and roll.
Yeah,
was Guns N' Roses with Mama Ken. Very high energy. The lyrics was just was off the wall. The band is going in on this song. They definitely doing their thing on this song. It's a great song. I definitely need to go back and listen to it again and really get the whole concept of Mama Ken. You know what I mean? This is my first time hearing it, so I'm not gonna grasp everything all at once. So I definitely need to go back and listen to it again so I can get the whole full concept of the song. This song was, listening to it is a great song. Listening to it. If you guys have,
as opposed to reading it, I guess.
Like, subscribe.
2 2 3s and F and N bullets.
In the comment box, like, subscribe.
2 2 3s and F and N bullets.
Finish what you're saying.
Better say your last goodbyes, cause your fans gon' miss
you. He interrupted himself.
So them headshots is not gon' miss you. A young coach, so I'm playing games with her mental.
You and I, Nathan, we are small potatoes. We know nothing. I mean, Hiphoppoet, he could have. One day he'll have 100,000 subs. He'll surpass us for sure. Mm-hmm. But here's a couple little tips, maybe. Maybe. When you do your outro part, maybe don't interrupt yourself. I do like the constant reminder that I'm on YouTube. I think that's... He has made it clear we're on a YouTube channel, YouTube video, and we can like, we can subscribe, we can upvote, we can thumbs up, you name it. And his comments of the song, very succinct. He listened to the song. The band was playing the song. You can't get everything off a first listen, which we have actually said before. Yes, it takes more than one listen to get everything. He's going to have to listen to the song again. My challenge to you, Hiphoppoet, is when you listen to the song again, because you said you would, I want a follow-up video on your thoughts of the song, because you didn't tell us anything. So now, that's my challenge to you. Is what are your thoughts to the song after you listen again? Nathan.
And we've done YouTube now for 2 years. We're no experts here. This is just advice from...
A couple old guys. You know.
Old guys that don't really know much about anything. But it's fair advice to say, beginning of your video, try and give a little bit of substance what you're going to say. Him moving around in the video is fine.
He's feeling it. He's feeling it. A unique way of looking up at the ceiling. I've just never seen it before. Unique. I like it.
I think it's fair to say that when the video's done, it's good to listen to what you've heard and then say, this part I thought was interesting because this. People who love Guns N' Roses, it doesn't matter what band.
Yeah.
They want to hear what you think about the song and how it made you feel. And if you kind of just say, it was a good song, it's not enough for them to go off of. It has to like...
Right. That's great advice, dude. Great advice. Look at us helping out our fellow YouTubers. I like that.
Yeah,
that's we can learn from them, and maybe they can learn from us.
There you go.
All right, you ready for the next one?
So we got another one here.
Yeah, another GNR reactor. Let's just say Guns N' Roses. I don't think this will be our last time. What? This won't be our last. Your dog doesn't like this. I highly doubt this will be the last time that we watch other reactors reacting to Guns N' Roses because they're just that big of a band, and we hope we get to watch other reactors do this. So this is a reaction channel called Lisa's Reactions. I like that. It's clear to the point. This is Lisa. This is her reactions. The title of the song or the title she's given is the name of the video she gave the song is OMG, I'm Heart This Song. Okay. First time listening to Guns N' Roses, Sweet Child of Mine, and it says 1987 reaction. Now, did she have a time machine and go back and do this reaction? Sorry. I know. It's the grammar police in me. She's saying this is a 1987 reaction. I'm just sorry. I couldn't help myself, Lisa. I apologize. So the name of her channel again is Lisa's Reactions. She is the owner proprietor of her channel. This is Lisa's Reactions. So let's check out what the youth of today are.
Well, this is a song that you and I like,
oh, God, Sweet Child of Mine, please. We've been listening for 35 years. 35 years.
Honestly, it's my favorite song from them, to be honest.
It's a wonderful song. Okay, let's check out her thoughts here.
What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. Back to another video. Actions. Thanks, Lisa. Lisa Reactions. Today's reaction is good for you guys. First time listening to Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. I hope I pronounced that song right, because I've never really heard of this song. And to be honest with you guys, I never listened to any Guns N' Roses songs, but so far I like Welcome to the Jungle and Don't Cry. So this is going to be my third song listening to Guns N' Roses, and I'm so excited.
Now, she's saying she's never heard of any Guns N' Roses songs before at the start of her channel, because she kind of contradicted herself. She goes, I never heard any Guns N' Roses songs before, but I just listened to... Okay. Secondly, she goes, I hope I'm saying this right. Well, yeah, I just read Sweet Child of Mine. I mean, she said it perfectly. I don't know why she's doubting herself is what I'm saying. Yes, you said it perfectly, Lisa. It's called Sweet Child of Mine. And she almost sang it. I don't... Maybe she... like, either she's guessing how it sounds or...
This is
going to
be one of their hits.
Pause again. Pause again. Oh, it's not. Okay, sorry. Go back. Did she say this is going to be one of their hits? I think she did this reaction in 1987. I think this is. How did she go back in time? Because she said this could be one of their hits. She's right. It's like one of the biggest hits ever of their career.
I'm going to turn the volume down a little bit.
That comes in a little hot.
So. Let's get started, because Fuzzy's telling me this is going to be one of their hits.
Ow.
Okay, I got to pause this.
Okay.
This, I actually know from a TV commercial, but I did not know it was their guitarist.
Fair. Good for her to tell the truth.
I don't even know his name. God, what was his name? I think his name was, I forgot his name, though. But I didn't know it was that was their guitarist. I just remember the Capital One commercial when they're doing da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, that one I remember now.
It's a very
okay,
familiar,
okay, so this is
too.
Capital One song from the Capital One commercial. Okay. I'm sorry,
Capital One. The Capital One commercial.
I love the air guitar like anyone else, but this is the move my wife makes when she's going down on me. Watch. See, watch. Play it. Play it. See, watch this. All right, Nathan, let's see what her overall thoughts are on the song.
Yes.
Oh,
give that a thumbs up and applause. That is a hit. First time to do Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. Comment down below any suggested songs by Guns N' Roses, remaining the albums, down below this video. Hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. You can see some of these reactions. Goodbye, everybody. See you next reaction video.
All right. So, what are some helpful tips that we can give her, or anything that we can learn from Lisa ourselves, Nathan? Any tips first?
Well, I'll be very, very honest here. We're nobodies. We are two old fuddy-duddies that we have things to offer, but like our channel is, it is what it is. But we have learned a few things. And one of the things that I would say would really help you, Lisa, with your channel. Number one, audio is everything. If it's possible, it'd be great to pick up some kind of a little mic.
Yeah.
Because it's hard to hear what you're saying. And I think if you get a good mic, we could hear what you're saying. That would help. And then it'd be good to listen to your video when you put it out so that you can hear how loud it is. Because the comparison between when you talk and when the music comes on is so drastic. So to level out your levels so that they're somewhat even with each other. I think that would help. It's kind of a cute thing that you're doing here with this channel, and all the power to you. I really think that if you learn from some of your mistakes here, and you can actually pull this off.
So look for like a levelator or something with the music. So we want to hear the music in our ears in a nice way that I think I might have lost my hearing. Like, hey, it's rock and roll. If we lose our hearing during rock and roll, that's a good time to lose it. But we don't want to stop listening to rock and roll, Lisa. So bring down the levels a little bit on the volume in our listeners' ears. It comes out, it's almost distorted, and Axel sounded like he was singing through a tin can. I'm not sure what happened there with the audio mix. So yeah, keep up the good work. Keep up the enthusiasm. We love your enthusiasm, the thumbs up, the hearts, the telling you love the song. That's a legit reaction, right? Nathan and I, we're pretty boring when we react to songs. We're actually just listening. We're kind of this old fuddy-duddies. We're like just listening. You're very animated. Guitar, soloing, the hearts, the thumbs up. Hey, that's a reaction. We can learn from that, Nathan. Maybe you and I could be more animated in our reactions. Now, that's the good part. The bad part, or the critique there, Lisa, is just maybe at the end, again, we had the same problem with Hiphoppoet of the same video. You know, give some thoughts at the very end. Like, why did the guitar solo make you feel? Like, did you get the chills from it? What part of it did you like? Did you like Axel singing? If you don't know the names of the singers in the bands, just don't even bring it up. Nathan and I talk all the time about bands. We don't know the singers' names. Or just put up a Wikipedia page to the right of you. Grab their names. Even as you're listening, I do that sometimes. I cheat a little bit. As the song's playing, I'll look up things as the song's playing. You know, multitask a little bit. Just say, hey, I get why this song was popular in 87. I get why this song has lived so long in 35 years and still played today at concerts. People like to hear that reinforcing information why we too love the song after 35 years. That's part of that journey as reactors and audience. So there you go. Well, good luck to your channel. All the best, Lisa. Keep up the good work. Keep up the enthusiasm. All right. We're rooting for you.
Yeah. We'll keep an eye on you.
So that is it today, guys. We're just doing two reactors today. Let us know what you think of our journey as we explore not our competition. Let's be clear. We're helping people. Mm-hmm. We're building bridges. Mm-hmm. We want everyone to succeed on this platform. There's room for everybody. Put suggestions below in the comments below.
Really what we're doing here is a little bit of anything. If there's a reactor, you're kind of like, you guys should check this out. I want to know what you think of these guys. That's kind of what we're doing.
Yeah, if there's some big name reactors that you think are real or not real, or they kind of fake it, or they kind of cater to the audience.
Yeah.
Nathan and I will be more than happy to call them out. If they're young upstarts like Lisa and Hiphoppoet, send us their way as well so we can give them some fatherly advice on how they can make their channels better. Absolutely. All right.
Okay, that was fun. Thanks for hanging out with us, and we'll see you in the next one.